So I would not want to introduce myself to you guys. This video has been created to demonstrate the technical rig building knowledge and a means of sharing general rig building knowledge using the build-up process of a miniature land rig to show that timeline versus technical build and the integration of equipment at the same time. So we all started actually over here drawing this rig equipment identification drawing, and then we landed up building this miniature land rig, a fully functional miniature land rig. It took us around 5 weeks to build the entire miniature land rig with the rolling gear, but we did not use the other equipment like the power generator house or the mud system or the camp system. So all this build can be done at the same time in a 5 to 6 week process if you have all the equipment collected and ready to rock and roll. So the entire process was very mechanical, manual, without motorized equipment or machines. We used hacksaw, files, needle files, a tri-square, shears, measuring tape, a hand drilling machine, and a hammer. So these are the minimum equipment we use for the entire build project. So having the experience of getting involved in building around 25 rigs in my lifetime in the oil and gas was my duty to share my knowledge with everyone, to tell them rig building is unique to its construction, but it is as simple as it can get with the knowledge you have and the knowledge you want to share with everyone. The major rigs that I have been involved to start with was Tahara, the Sitco Forex semi-sub rig in India, where we installed a Kirloskar engine, and then it went to Rig 21, the assembly of a land rig in Rajasthan, Jaisalmer, and it carried on. It went further and further. I have a list and I can read out the list to you. It went further and further. It went into Rig 31, 32 in Oman for NDSC, Rig 96 in Magram Field, Abu Dhabi, Rig 11 in Syria, Rig 8 in Oman, Rig 96 again in Oman, and the Bima, the jackup in Brunei, to Rig 98 build in Houston, Texas, and also Rig 828, 829, 830, the Lotono land rigs at Dubai, Jabal Ali, and 826, the commissioning at Western Australia, Dombra, through Geraldton. I remember going there to commission this rig in 2008, and the 801 in Bangladesh, and the rig 100 in the Cooper Basin, as well as the CSG rigs 8 and 9 in Chinchilla, as well as Toowoomba, and rig 4, the build at Westchester in close to Pennsylvania, which was the USA. And then we had the great opportunity of building rigs for China, which was 80 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, and I had an opportunity to work on 253 in Indonesia. So it's around 27 rigs total. But I'm sorry for making it too long and adding to my rig count. So in Barmer it was 806, 807 and 709, as well as the first 3000 horsepower rig built in Jabal Ali, AD 23 and AD 36. And this was in the year 2006. So my rig count of direct involvement with rig building is more than 27-30 rigs. And the rigs which I have really worked, a total number of say 45 to 47 rigs, which are land, offshore, semi-sub, drill ship, jack-up, land rig, tenders, etc., etc. So this sums up everything in my 37 years of oil and gas experience. I hope you will enjoy this excellent video and enjoy my miniature land rig, which is fully functional and the first probably functional miniature land drilling rig probably in the world, if I'm right or maybe not. Cheers and enjoy the entire video. Therefore, I thought I would come forward and share my rig building knowledge and tell you guys exactly how a rig is built with the different phases, the different structural requirement, the different anticipation of internal test plan, the FAT, the factory acceptance test, and the endurance testing at X-Works, and as well as the endurance testing to be done at the site before commissioning or before starting a drilling operation. I hope you will enjoy the whole video. I'm sorry it's getting too long. I think I will cut short for the moment and let us talk soon. But if I missed something, the maximum build time simultaneous, if you're building only the rig package with all the equipment available, then I would say you would take around 6 months to build 5 rigs, 2000 horsepower simultaneously, and it is achievable and we have done it. So thank you guys and enjoy the time lapse video all the way till the end. And don't forget to watch till the end and go to the Pice Coffee YouTube channel, and you will find all the links to all the entire processes. You can click on each one of them and you will know exactly the different phases by date. You can search for them and go through them. Thank you, God bless, and see you all soon in my next video as soon as I can.
Wow, amazing rigging. What the hell is going on? Oh, picking up pipe, eh? Oh. So looks like this is a land rig 2000 horsepower. Okay, let's go and check the components. So today I'll be showing you. So let me explain to you on a land rig or a jack-up rig leaving. It's very, very important, very, very important. Okay, I'll give you a small glimpse of the drizzle here. Okay, let's start here. Now, one was open sleigh, all the way we go, marching all the way. So today we fitted the pump with its V-bends and aligned the pump.
Oh, sorry, the returns from the zero discharge will not come into.
the good. Also, we got together in the assembly on the other side. Going in with the key for any engineering design, right? The annular. But the orientation is different. I rather take. The minimum requirement to get everything lined up fair and square and a proper aligned substrate. You see, the fitting has to be accurate, your measurement has to be. Get the substructure installed and it will go for painting soon. Okay, we're very happy with the fitment. You can see here, lovely, excellent. Fittings are there, everything looks good. The deltron excess is also there. The crown assembly is now installed. Miniature standpipe manifold. Now we will work on the painting. Standpipe manifold painting. Precision is key. Right angle, very important. It's very important. There you go. Two different parts. And this is the third end. Wow. Square, right? You have to check with the other leg. All have to be square. Square straight to you with the top drive running. And we have returns, which is a good sign. The only way you can determine that your calculation is correct for the flow line and the mud return system is you need to ensure run three pumps with its full potential and then make sure you don't have overflow on your possibility tank. That is the calculation. If you can do this, then you have achieved your flow system working correctly for a new build. So it's almost ready. We'll build a plant. It's ready to rock. Rotating, and then find a way to get the wire line inside to meet a dead end. We achieved the assembly of robots. We just need to secure. Company is good. The braking system is fine. Enjoy the operation of the drawers. Plug. Okay. Running. Plug. The driller's control room framework. So the functional driller's control room or the driller's cabin is ready and good to rock and roll. Let me take you inside. Oh my. Coupling insulation. To be very honest, the fuck. So we have decided to go with the double line. This way we can reduce the load on the motor and the